We had a small engineering class here at Ygnacio Valley High School.
All right, everyone listen up.
My students said, we want to do something more. We want to do robotics.
Monday through Friday, we'd be here until 6, 7, 8. Saturdays are even more intense.
Yes, you can say that again.
Oh my gosh, like these people are just like me. They're just passionate about something and they're going towards it. I've always been interested in like designing things and just making things. So I had to really become creative with what I had on hand.
It was really difficult coming here, not knowing English. I felt out of place.
I never expected to use a computer in school because I grew up poor. Now I do all this cool stuff with robots.
This room was closed for 8 years. It was a dumping ground. Unwanted old machines here, bird poop all around. That's how we started. Room 212, hence Project 212.
Can I have the orange wrench?
Why do you keep doing this?
Because I'm crazy. Ygnacio Valley High School is a Title I school, which means we cater to underserved community. We have students who can't afford this type of program. So when I heard about what FIRST Robotics can offer, I believe that this is something that could change the lives of students here at YV.
The problem that we have with the pit before is that all of our tools were all around the place, and when we need something, right, we can't find the thing that we need. That's why you guys organized it this year.
I moved here in 2015 from San Francisco de Rincón, Guanajuato, Mexico. I just started seeing all of this more advanced technology and I got inspired by it.
I was really just a shy kid. School started, they were like, we have this robotics club. Hey, that's kind of interesting. I want to join.
Robot. In FIRST Robotics, the season starts in January. You're supposed to be building a robot that would perform certain tasks. Let's say, pick up a ball and shoot the ball. And at the end, your robot needs to raise itself up on a platform. The kids are given 7 weeks to 8 weeks in order for them to finish that robot.
My role was to create the arm subsystem. I had to really communicate between elevator and claw to make sure like, okay, you need to be able to hold this much of my weight and of the claw's weight.
I like the testing because you get to test it until it breaks, which is really fun to me. You know, we just go really hard with the robot, and if it breaks, it's a good thing for us because, you know, that means that we know what not to do and we also know what to change as well.
We were thinking, okay, do we want a rigid arm or a telescopic? We had to prototype as quickly as possible and get the best design going.
We have a lot of dedicated students. 75% are Hispanic, and then 40% are females. This is intentional. What we're trying to do here is balance the scales.
Coming into high school, the people that I looked up to as a kid actually told me that I couldn't go to college because I was a woman. I was really discouraged from pursuing engineering as a career. One of the things that actually Ms. Alvarico said that made me like really stick to this was, I'm gonna make a leader out of you.
I always encourage the kids, don't let our situation stop you from doing your best, creating your best.
Thank you all so much for being here. Hello everyone, and welcome to the Project 212 2023's Robot Reveal. The team worked tirelessly together to create a revolutionizing robot for competition. With a job like this, of a team's hard work in 7 weeks, 4,885 hours, how can it be done without mentors?
When we started this team, the mentors and I thought about, what are we doing this for? Are we doing this for winning? For us, the learning is the number one thing. We're here to teach the kids and make sure that they learn valuable skills that they could use in life.
I had no idea how much opportunity these students have to learn not only about engineering, but marketing and communication. I was in high school many years ago, and I so wished that there was something like this.
The moment you've all been waiting for. Listen up, team. When I say 2-1, you say 2. 2-1. 2-1. When I say full, you say crumb. Full.
Crumb.
Do you know where the robot is? It's coming.
Go up.
Elevator.
Oh, no. They won't fit.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. We really need to get a trailer.
There's some serious teams. Teams just that are just way better than we are. It feels like a coliseum, like a gladiator fight. It's terrifying.
Hey, let's keep doing that, and then let's just keep testing our shooting cube up high. Because if we can perfect backing up, hey, bro, we're godly.
Hey, guys, can you stop working? We have a special guest here. Okay, she's an engineer, and she's here to find out more about your robot.
Tell me about your robot. What's your strategy here?
So basically, for this game, we ended up with a West Coast drivetrain. The main pivot is right here.
Nice.
So we can reach on the floor.
So can you do floor pickup of the cones?
Yep, we can pick up anywhere.
Love it. Love it. So you can do cubes and cones.
From any position, from anywhere.
How people think of a problem and how to solve it, that's what changes every robot to be unique.
So you said, we've already said like what we do, so what do you do?
Oh, what do I do? I'm the CEO of PG&E. Okay, go get him.
I can. Justin.
Let's go, drive team.
Just get the cone. Let's go. Keep going.
Okay, back on drive seat.
Let's go, baby.
The bolts broke and also bent.
I'm glad we got through that round then.
We improved our communications, definitely. That's how that game went. Because the last one, we were just like all over the place. So our autonomous code says that it won't back up because it's an emergency. And we don't know why yet. It's been doing that all day. So we're gonna try to figure it out.
I always tell the kids, we have to do with the cards that were dealt to us. If you just believe in yourself, you guys could compete with some of the best teams out there.
I'm the first woman in my family to do engineering. Seeing other women really has inspired me to teach other people that just because you're this gender does not mean that you have boundaries. In fact, those boundaries are invisible. This club has actually opened my eyes to like, oh, I can actually do this.
Kids come to me with no background in robotics. They're unsure of themselves if they can even do this. But going through the program, they grow, they learn skills that could lead them to a career.
I came here with like one friend, but now I'm part of like this really awesome community.
Mr. Alvarico, he's not just a mentor. He's one of my friends too. I'm this outgoing person now. I'm a leader now. He's changed that for me.
My parting words to the kids is that now that you've tasted success, now that you've seen what you're capable of doing, there's no looking back.
Continue to support your journey in STEM education, I'd like to present you with a $10,000 check from PG&E. So the $10,000 is going to the purchase of the first trailer